Whether you just picked ProtonVPN or you just want a refresher at the start of the new year, don't worry, this ProtonVPN tutorial will deliver. I'm gonna review everything from installation to basic features and advanced settings. To begin with, you do need to know how to obtain a ProtonVPN subscription and which one to choose. That said, the only difference is the subscription length, amongst which annual and biannual plans have the best value. So feature-wise, they are all identical. So I recommend the biannual plan if you want to save as much money as possible. Hey, and don't worry, not only is it more affordable, but I also have a ProtonVPN coupon code you can activate through the link in the description or by scanning this QR code. Now that you have a subscription, the next step is the ProtonVPN download and installation. For folks using macOS, iOS, and Android, this is a matter of clicking just one button in the respective app stores. But if you are installing ProtonVPN for PC, you gotta download the installer from the provider's website. Once that's done, it is worth noting how ProtonVPN's UI looks extremely similar on Windows and macOS, as well as iOS and Android. The transition is gonna be smooth if you decide to switch devices or add a new one. Okay, time to get into the nitty gritty with ProtonVPN's main functions. All right, ProtonVPN makes it really easy to start. I often just click Quick Connect and enjoy whatever servers ProtonVPN picks, knowing that it's always gonna have optimal performance. I don't even worry, is ProtonVPN safe or not? Their encryption is top-notch, okay? Not just encryption, but privacy and safety have always been one of the main reasons that people pick ProtonVPN. After all, it does have a privacy-friendly jurisdiction, an audited no-logs policy, and beyond everything, it maintains transparency with open-source code. So that said, I do often need a specific location for streaming or torrenting. If you also want that, follow me on the map UI. Okay, here I can click any part of the world and just choose a server. Alternatively, go ahead and use the search bar on the side. Currently, ProtonVPN has around 10,000 servers in 117 countries, but with how fast they expand, just don't blame me if this number goes up again. All right, but since we are talking about servers, let's take a look at the server icons. Yeah, those tiny ones. First is the triangle symbol or play button. Fittingly, this icon indicates servers optimized for streaming. They're designed to provide a better experience when accessing various streaming platforms worldwide. And I just have to say that YouTube strongly recommends that I not endorse this. So let's just pretend I'm not doing that. Moving on, the second icon is the globe one. It indicates servers using smart routing technology, which provides IP addresses from specific countries while physically located elsewhere. I don't know why I'm overcomplicating this. Those are just virtual servers in countries where VPN is typically unavailable. Think Iran, India, Turkey, and so on. The third icon is supposed to look like an onion and refers to the onion router, or Tor. In short, the Tor network utilizes a series of nodes worldwide to create complicated and hard to track connections. If you want top anonymity and don't care about your internet becoming a snail, that's a must have. But if a snail's pace is too slow for you, try Turtle instead. This lock symbol is for secure core servers, which route connections through multiple servers for enhanced privacy and security. They are slightly faster than Tor, but almost as secure. All right, that was the fifth icon, so let's return back to the fourth one. This double-sided arrow, this is for the P2P servers, better known as torrenting servers. These servers are gonna ensure better file sharing performance and security. Finally, the wrench icon is for servers currently under maintenance and otherwise unavailable. All right, now that you know what those icons do, here's a quick guide on how to check if your VPN connection is working properly, which is gonna show you your IP address and location. Now connect to any VPN server and reload the page. If nothing changes, we're dealing with an IP leak. But in my experience, ProtonVPN is completely leak-proof, and you'll soon see why. All right, while this information is enough for casual users, I did promise that this VPN tutorial is gonna show you all the important features, so let's go for it. Starting with the very core, the kill switch. If it's enabled, it's gonna automatically block internet access if any VPN issue is detected. This is done to prevent all IP and data leaks. If disabled, I don't know what you're doing, but stop, it's invaluable. All right, on par with the kill switch, DNS leak protection ensures that all DNS requests are handled through the VPN connection. Granted, this is a bit slower than usual, but it prevents my ISP or data collection services from spying on me, so it is worth it. In a similar manner, I'll mention the IPv6 support here, ProtonVPN can guarantee that all IPv6 traffic is also protected. Those two are enabled by default, so you can just leave them alone. All right, now if you do browse a lot and find yourself annoyed to death by ads, phishing websites, and other crap like that, enable NetShield. To do that, go to the settings, then features, then finally NetShield. With this advanced ad blocker, you'll block this stuff and also actively detect online threats headed your way and stop them. Plus, having an ad block built into my VPN saves me the hassle of getting a standalone app or ProtonVPN extension. The same can be said about ProtonPass. That's a built-in password manager. So ProtonPass might not be as big and fancy as 1Password or NordPass, but it's effective at keeping my password safe, detecting weak ones, and providing replacement with a customizable password generator. To activate it, you just log into your Proton account at their website and then download the extension from the ProtonPass section. After you have it installed, the extension is super straightforward, just like I've demonstrated. So if you're an advanced user, ProtonVPN allows you to play with your internet ports using port forwarding. Opening specific ports can improve performance for certain apps and activities such as server hosting and torrenting. If you're a beginner, I won't show you how to use this one since it's too easy to screw everything up if you're not careful. So one more performance-oriented feature is the VPN accelerator, which promises to boost my speed by 400%. Does it work? Yeah, but not really. The speeds get faster, sure, but it's nowhere near quadrupling. It's a nice to have, but I'd prefer not to get embellished advertising. If you still want that small boost, go to settings, then the connections tab, and from there enable the VPN accelerator. All right, moving on, two-factor authentication, or 2FA for short, is a simple but crucial feature. With 2FA, you can enable extra verification for your account, for example, through an authenticator app or biometric method such as fingerprint or scanning. The settings are going to differ depending on your device, but in any case, you can find the feature in the settings tab and then choose which verification method fits you the best. All right, if you have any questions after this ProtonVPN tutorial 2025, feel free to ask in the comment section. Hey, I hope you learned everything you needed in this video. If you did, consider dropping a like and subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon in another video. Bye.